Good evening, and welcome to the Cathedral of the Most Sacred Heart of Jesus. My name is Glenn Kaler. I'm the Cathedral's Director of Music and Liturgy and Cathedral Concerts. It is my pleasure to welcome you to this, the 69th installment of the Cathedral Concert Series. But most importantly, this is the unique and singular moment in the history of this cathedral and of this cathedral parish, a most auspicious moment indeed. Through a generous gift from Alan and Sally Sefton, we are blessed and honored to present the completion of Casavant Frères Pipe Organ Opus 3927 and this inaugural dedication concert. We would also like to mention that Alan and Sally are along with us tonight, along with their family and close friends. The rest of their family and friends are also joining via the live stream in places like England and elsewhere. And please allow me to be the first to thank you for your contribution and for your support for the Seftons as well. Before we begin, just a few logistical points of interest. In the event of an unlikely emergency, please calmly make your way to one of the green exit signs. There are about 10 different ways in and out of the cathedral. Restrooms are located off the main entrance vestibule at the back of the church. You can find women restrooms down off the south side, men's restrooms through a small labyrinthian passage on the north side. If you have any questions or need any assistance whatsoever, please don't hesitate to approach one of our cathedral ushers. They are clearly marked with that maroon baldric or sash, and they would be happy to help you with your needs. Finally, without further ado, I would like to invite Father David Boatner, our rector of the cathedral, forward to make some opening remarks.
Good evening. What a joy it is to be together this evening to experience the wonder of the completion of our cathedral pipe organ. There's so many people who have been involved in this project, and I will not go down the road of risking forgetting someone, but I do want to thank all of those who have helped to make this possible, especially Alan and Sally Sefton and their families. Also, for the many professionals and volunteers who have given their time and energy to this project, and you who get to experience the joy of hearing what a wonderful gift this is, not only to our cathedral parish, but to this entire community of East Tennessee. And that was one of the dreams when we began the project to build this cathedral, was that this would be a home for all people, that everyone should feel welcome here, that there would be many different ways to invite and welcome and fellowship with our brothers and sisters in this community. And so this evening, I want to invite you into prayer as we begin. And first, I want to share with you from the Acts of the from the Apostle Paul to the Colossians. Put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, heartfelt compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience, bearing with one another and forgiving one another. If one has a grievance against another, as the Lord has forgiven you, so must you also do. And over all these put on love, that is the bond of perfection. And let the peace of Christ control your hearts, the peace into which you were also called in one body, and be thankful. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, as in all wisdom you teach and admonish one another, singing psalms, hymns, and spiritual songs with gratitude in your hearts to God. And whatever you do, in word or in deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, we gather this evening to give thanks and praise to your name for the many and wonderful ways you work in our midst. We thank you for the generosity that has brought us together. We thank you for the love and the ministry which gathers us. We thank you for this evening and this opportunity to share together in your sacred house. We ask you to bless us and all those who may enter here through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And now I'd like to invite Alan Sefton to come forward and share a few remarks on behalf of his family.
Good evening and welcome. You have to bear with me, it's been a few years since I've done this. My involvement in the concept of holding cathedral concerts goes back to when we decided to build a new cathedral. For business reasons, my wife and I relocated to the USA more than 34 years ago. Prior to this, I was a regular supporter of concerts in such organizations as the Royal Albert Hall, St. Martin's in the Fields, etc., and truly enjoyed such performances. Past experiences created a desire to hold similar concerts when our new cathedral was finally built. Along with some local music professionals, a lawyer and a medical doctor, we formed a small committee which headed up discussions with the diocese regarding the use of the sacred space and the associated need to apply reverence where appropriate. Some of that original dedicated group are with us this evening, and I truly thank them for their time in those early days helping bring this where we are today. It was not until I considered that we needed a full-time leader to make a concept really did it take off. The appointment of Glenn Kaler, music director, and the establishment of the Knoxville Music Commission was a stroke of genius. The dream that was a founding objective emphasized the bringing together of the communities within the greater Knoxville area using the common, universal, understood language of music, and the sharing of our beautiful space and the incorporation of the multifaceted talents available here in Knoxville, thereby making music all for the glory of God. Why the organ? My wife Sally and I have continued to support cathedral concerts from its very beginning to the current day. I was personally amazed that the diocese actually managed to get a basis of a Casavant Frères organ specified, ordered, constructed, and installed in time for the cathedral dedication in 2019. 4 years on, Sally and I felt that as we have an amazing organist, we should make sure he has the best instrument to ensure that he can fully exemplify his skills. We needed the missing parts to make a complete instrument. A remote console would also enhance future organ concerts. Many of you will have noticed the additional bank of pipes to the left of the rose window, and it's now more visually balanced. We have now a total of 71 stops and over 58 ranks and 3,281 pipes. God has guided me well over the years in business, and Sally and I were pleased to be able to share these gifts to make universal music for the glory of God, to bring people from all denominations together, to improve understanding and develop a full appreciation of music and of each other. As far as I know, Sally and I have been the sole sponsors of the cathedral concerts from its inception. The momentum has increased dramatically as it's our 69th concert from inception. We would therefore like you to consider becoming an annual sponsor of the series. Glenn Kaler will have more information on this should you be interested. Please enjoy the concert.
Now please offer a warm welcome to our performers this evening, Dr. Byongsuk Moon, Deacon Walt Otey, and Miss Michelle Pokelwaldt.
Thank you. My heart ever faithful, sing praises, be joyful, sing praises, be joyful, thy Jesus is near. My heart ever faithful, sing praises, be joyful, sing praises, be joyful, thy Jesus is near. Away with complaining, away with complaining, faith ever maintaining, thy Jesus is near. Away with complaining, faith ever maintaining, thy Jesus is here, thy Jesus is here. Away with complaining, away with complaining, faith ever maintaining, thy Jesus is here. My heart ever grateful, sing praises, be joyful. My heart ever faithful, sing praises, be joyful, sing praises, be joyful, thy Jesus is here. Sing praises, be joyful, sing praises, be joyful. My heart ever faithful, sing praises, be joyful, sing praises, be joyful, my Jesus is here. This day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, for thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory.
as sometimes happens when you have a new instrument, we have a little glitch. Fortunately, we have one of the executives with Casavant here who has run upstairs to see if he can fix the glitch. So be about a 5-minute intermission, and we'll be back with you shortly.
So I'll tell you a little about pipe organs while we have a couple of minutes to wait. A pipe organ is a fascinating instrument. I mean, it's as much art and culture as it is science and physics. And the physics side and science side just derailed that last piece momentarily, hopefully. We actually had Simone Couture, the vice president of Casavant Frères, happened to be in the house tonight, and he is currently, if you can see, up inside the organ cabinet, desperately trying to fix what we call an organ cipher. A cipher, so it's at the bottom of the wind chest, a little electromagnet pulls down when you reverse the polarity. That allows high pressure wind from the wind chest to go into the pipe to make it sound. Like everyone has probably blown on the a pop bottle before, right? Ooh, 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 right? That's the general principle behind the pipe. Now, when an organ cipher happens, that electromagnet got reversed in polarity, but it never rebounded. So then that pipe is permanently stuck open. That is an organ cipher. And you just learned something tonight. Hopefully it's a quick fix. He is working on it right now, so please bear with us. I will get back with you in just a couple of minutes with a determination of whether or not that can be fixed, but at the very least, we can pull the pipe, right? Okay. So I realized I said pop bottle before, and a lot of you looked at me funny. So you could clearly, I'm from the north, right? It should be a Coke bottle, right, or something like that. So I got news that we ended up unelectrifying that electromagnet that was failing. So we, in essence, pulled the pipe. So I believe we are ready to get back to where we left off. On behalf of Father David Boatner, on behalf of Alan and Sally Sefton and their families, and all of us here at the Cathedral and the Cathedral staff, we would like to thank you for being a part of this celebration, this marked celebration in the history of our parish, and thank you for that as well. For your support of the Cathedral Concert Series as well, you'll see on the backs of your programs at the bottom, you'll see all the upcoming concerts we have up through summer. We hope to see you again at the next. For those of you who received a special invitation, I made those and sent those to you. You know who you are. You can find the private reception with Alan and Sally will be up in the Cathedral Parish Hall, which is out this door and just up the stairway. It's clearly marked with signage as well. You can make your way just out this door and up that stairway or ramp to get checked in for the private reception. For everyone else, we also thank you once again for being with us to celebrate this completed Casavant organ, save one magnet, as we all discovered. We hope that you go forth with great rejoicing, and the Lord willing that we will see you the next time. Thank you, God bless, and good night.